Hello everyone, today we will study the pyrolytic elimination. Yes, so the some organic compounds undergoes elimination reactions at the high temperature into the gas phase, and such a reactions are considered as a pyrolytic elimination reactions. This pyro stands for heat, okay, and these reactions can also be carried out in a high boiling solvent without using any base. And in this reaction, the bond breaking and bond making takes place simultaneously, and it results into the formation of cyclic transition state. And these reactions are, therefore, these reactions are concerted. These are also called as EI reactions. Means these are intramolecular eliminations, and these are taking place at the high temperature through the cyclic transition state. Okay, so these are also considered as a types of pericyclic reactions. Let's consider the first pyrolytic elimination, that is the pyrolysis of acetate. Yes, let's consider first ester. That will be RCH2CH2. Okay, now this ester having beta hydrogen atom, okay, consider this as a alpha carbon atom, which is attached to the functional group. This will be the beta carbon atom, okay. Now this ester having beta hydrogen atom into the alkyl group, it gets heated at the high temperature, consider here 500 degree celsius, okay, and in this case this ester eliminates the carboxylic acid and it forms alkene. Yes, now consider this reaction, this bond gets broken, and hydrogen from this carbon atom, that is beta hydrogen atom, gets eliminated, and between these two the double bond is formed, okay, and the product formed will be R. One hydrogen atom from this position gets eliminated, so it will be CH double bond CH2, okay, and this hydrogen gets attached to this oxygen and it will form CH3COOH, that is the acetic acid. Okay, so esters which are having beta hydrogen atoms in alkyl group, when heated at the high temperature, they eliminates the carboxylic acid and it forms alkenes. Okay, next let's consider the mechanism for the pyrolysis of acetate. This is the one step reaction. Let's consider the mechanism first. The ester which is having beta hydrogen atom can be shown as like this. Okay, so this is the ester which is having beta hydrogen atom. Consider this as a alpha carbon atom and this will be the beta carbon atom. Okay, so hydrogen from the beta carbon atom, that is this, can be eliminated. Okay, and this reaction takes place at the 500 degree Celsius. Okay, and here first bond making and bond breaking takes place simultaneously. See, this bond gets broken. Here the new bond formation will take place. This bond gets broken. Here the new bond formation will take place. And this bond gets broken. Between the hydrogen and oxygen, the new bond formation will take place. Okay. So the cyclic transition state for the reaction can be written as, see, this bond starts breaking. Between these two, the bond starts forming. This bond starts breaking. Between these two, the bond starts forming. And this bond starts breaking. Yes, between the hydrogen and oxygen, the new bond starts forming. Okay, so this will be the cyclic transition state for the pyrolysis of acetate. Okay, so in this case the bond making and bond breaking takes place simultaneously, forming cyclic transition state. Okay, so this is also called as concerted reaction. Okay, and after this it eliminates this acetone, sorry, it eliminates this acetic acid and it forms alkene. Okay. See how the elimination will take place. Here RCH, double bond CH2, alkene is formed by eliminating this. Combine this OH by eliminating acetic acid, the formation of alkene will take place. Okay, so this will be the mechanism for the pyrolysis of acetate, and this is the first order reaction because only one molecule is involved into the reaction. Okay, and here the cyclic transition state is formed, and this is the concerted reaction. And in this case, the groups which are eliminated from the same side, so this is also called as cis elimination. Okay, clear?